Get ready to match the stars. Artie Johnson, Rhett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Michelle Lee, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Raver.
Johnny Olson, thank you, dear friends and gentle hearts. How is everybody
Isn't
over here?
Lovely,
are you terrific? What's that?
Simply divine.
Oh, that's great.
I'd swim the Panama Canal to make him mine. Where'd you get that suit?
I don't know. I just found it in the dressing room.
Where'd you get that song?
Well, I'm sorry to say that this will be the last show that Charles Nelson Reilly will be on for a while here.
Just for a little while.
Which one is Charles Nelson Reilly? I've been sitting up here with these two. I have never been able to tell which one is Brett and which one is Charles.
The one with the dress is Charles. I'm the one with the,
that's Charles.
That's Charles over
the
there.
Hairy one.
The hairy one.
She's going to have my child. I'd much rather be away.
How would you like to pick at that litter, folks?
I have something to say.
Yes, what?
What else? And I mean this absolutely sincerely.
Uh-oh, I'm leaving.
Now Richard has to.
I'm going to cry the entire time Charles is gone because I love him so much.
That's nice to hear. We all love you, Charles.
Good luck to you.
Thank you. I'm coming back very soon.
He's going to New York to do a play. He starts rehearsals in a couple of days.
Oh,
yes, Richard.
We do a lot of joking and, you know, together and everything. I despise you.
No, it's the best job I ever had, and you know how we have a good time.
Yes.
You come early and you go late, but I'll go on Broadway, see how that thing is, and come right back.
Okay.
Better.
All right, now let's say hello to our current champion, Edith Noble. Last time we were together, she had just finished winning a game, and we're going to start with the Big Money audience match. You ready for that?
Yes.
All right, we'll do that. You're up to $800. We'll see how much more you get after this message. Well, here we are again with Edith Noble. This is the third time you're up here, right?
Yep.
Are you getting to like it?
Yes,
good.
I like it.
Now, you're up to $800, Edith. We'll see how much more you're going to win right now. Shall we begin?
Mm-hmm.
We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Blank sin.
Ooh.
The answer they gave most often, as you know, is worth $500 if you match it. Then if you match the next one, you get $250. If you match a bottom one, you get $100. Which celebrities would you like an assist from?
Richard.
Something that Charles wears around the house. My sin.
Okay.
Next week he'll wear your sin.
I do not.
Well, you
and
I hear that's
evening
all he wears.
Paris.
Oh, evening in Paris.
Evening in Paris.
All right,
Paris.
Who else?
Okay, Charles.
Charles.
Mortal sin.
Mortal sin.
All right. And Brett.
And Brett. Brett, what do you say?
How about deadly sin?
Deadly sin. So you have deadly
well,
sin.
Number three, it's tricky, you know.
Mortal sin and my sin.
What?
Edith, do you want one of those answers, or would you like to give us one of your own?
Mortal.
You want mortal sin? All right. I don't know what kind of audience we got here, but they applauded mortal sin there. You applauded mortal sin there. Okay, mortal sin's the one she's looking for. Let's find out if it's up there, and if it's there, where is it? Is it under the $100 response? I ask you that. No, it is not. Living in sin.
Ooh.
Aha. All right.
Why
we
didn't
know
we
your
think
secret.
Of that?
Here we go, looking for mortal sin. Is it under the $250 response? Yes, it is. Congratulations. Now you're up to $1,050. Now, before we go on to see how much more she will earn, what do you think is under the $500,000?
My sin.
My sin. All right, let's find out. Would you open it? There it is. My sin.
Why did you doubt me?
Yep. Okay. Now, Edith, you've... What is that?
That's my sin. That's the song.
Oh, that's a song, yes. Very well done, too.
Thank you.
Okay.
I know.
Now, Edith, you're going to be playing for $2,500. Which celebrity would you choose now to match head-to-head on that?
Charles.
Charles. Ready?
Get ready, kids.
Okay. Here we go.
Remember, this is your last show for a long, long time. But don't get nervous.
She's charming.
Yes, sounds like Kay Medford. Here it is. Ready? Little Red Blank. Shh. Little Red Blank.
I never get those.
You never get those?
No, I get Handy Andy, Andy White.
Listen, I got news for you. He's having trouble with it.
Well, he has trouble with walking.
Little Red... Oh, now he's finished. Now, what answer would you like to give us which will match Charles Nelson Reilly's?
Riding Hood.
Little Red Riding Hood. Well, there are other choices there. What do you say, Charles? For $2,500, Little Red Riding Hood is what she says.
Despite the fact that you and Dawson and our producer will probably think I'd be terrific in the leading role, I am turning down the leading role of Little Red Riding Hood right
yeah!
now.
What did that say there?
That can work.
Congratulations. Okay. Now, Edith Noble is up to $3,550, and she's getting up there with the big boys. Now, you ready to play another game?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's bring on another player. Now, here comes Alicia Howard. Hello there.
Hi.
Get aboard the merry-go-round. Alicia, you know Edith Noble, our current champion. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
You ready?
Yes, I am.
You want to tell us who Alicia Howard is?
All right. I'm a housewife, and I'm married to a chiropractor. And we have three children, Holly, 8, and Wendy, 5, and Kurt, 3. And they're all fans of Match Game.
They are?
Yeah, they are.
No kidding. The 3-year-old, how does that work?
Oh, he loves it.
He does?
Right. He tries.
What's his favorite part of the program?
The lights and things, you know, right? At 3 years old, right.
Yeah. All right, shall we have a go at it? There we go. Alicia, please make a selection there.
A, please.
Just made the lighting man very happy there. Love your lights. Just don't go dark on me, that's all.
In all fairness, that's what attracted Charles to the match.
The bright lights.
The bright lights and the dinging and the buzzer.
And the striped suits.
Yes.
Don't forget those.
Now, did I miss something?
No, here it is.
The question.
This is it. Are you ready?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I got good news and bad news.
All right, give us the good news first.
No, the bad news first.
Oh. All right, well, then give us the bad news.
All right.
The bad news is
Charles Nelson Reilly is going away for a while.
Well, you did give us the good news.
No, I gave you the bad news.
What's
first.
What's the good news?
The good news is we're going to blank his chair.
Oh, I got it.
You don't think that's good news, do you? Well, I say it's good news. And if I say it's good news, you write down a good news answer.
All righty.
Good news and bad news. Bad news is Charles Nelson Reilly's going away for a while. The good news is we're going to blank his chair.
I want everyone to notice that Charles did not hide his answer this time. That he did not go like this.
He didn't.
That he finished after I did. Now, audience, you can draw your own conclusions when you see his answer.
Do not harass Charles. He may not come back. All right.
Harris,
the accent is on the first syllable. Because otherwise it sounds funny.
Nelson Harris.
Alicia Howard, got good news and bad news. The bad news is Charles Nelson Reilly's going away for a while. The good news is we're going to blank his chair.
Bronze
his chair. Bronze his chair, she said, in tribute. What do you say?
I thought it was I felt that this was a very wealthy organization, so I said instead of bronze, I said gild his chair.
Well, gild and bronze is the same thing, isn't it? Yeah, certainly. That's a classy answer. What do you say there? Hello, Brett.
Hi there. I just get so upset when I think about Charles leaving for all that time, you know? We're going to bronze it, and then we're going to place it in his blank.
That's two for you, Charles.
I said the same thing, bronze.
Bronze his chair. You're up to 3, Alicia, doing very well. Michelle.
Unfortunately.
What?
I thought of bronze originally.
And you rejected that?
No, I wanted to be nice and everything, so I thought you would hold his chair, meaning you will keep it for him to come back to.
I told you to trust your first instinct. You won't listen to me.
I'm learning. You know, I have to learn.
Okay. All right.
Give her the boo.
You don't have to boo me.
You don't
want to hold this chair?
Yeah, we're going to hold this chair.
They're giving me fingers down on top of the box.
Richard, what do you say? What's on your mind, Richard?
I just get so sad when I think of...
of Charles. I already said that.
I get so sad when I think Charles is coming back.
Anyway, I put bronze.
Bronze! There's another one. Alicia, you're up to four.
This is not my answer. This was my first instinct, which was bronze. My answer was what I know is really going to happen. There's going to be a warm body in that chair tomorrow.
I'm going to fill his chair. Okay, so you did well with that. You're up to four. Your question coming along in a minute or so, but right now, coming your way is this message. Okay, are you ready? You got your work cut out for you, haven't you?
Yes.
Well, you're going to have two shots at it, so don't worry about it. All right, here we go.
Yes.
Hey, not many people know this, but there were actually two portraits of George Washington crossing the Delaware. You didn't know that?
No.
Yeah. You know, there's the famous one.
Yeah.
The one where he's standing up at the boat. Remember that one?
Yeah.
And then there's the other one where Washington is blanking over the side. Of the boat.
Yeah.
Famous one. Remember the one where he's standing in the bow of the boat?
You'll never get away from me.
That's right.
If you climb the tallest tree.
You really want me something? You know, you really want me to write those
well,
kind of things down?
Well, let me just see. Now, you write it and I'll...
Get away from me.
Go ahead. I'm watching. Splendid.
I don't think this show can stay out of here.
That's the way it's
kind of.
Okay.
Can I see that again? Because it seems to be a...
There it is.
It's got to be something.
That's a very long, boring question, but that's the best we can do there. All right?
Oh, okay.
Okay. Everybody ready up here? Everybody ready down there? And we'll come right over here to Youth Noble. Did you hear all that about George Washington, the famous picture, the one with his standing in the bow of the boat, but very few people knew about the other picture, where Washington is blanking over the side?
Vomiting.
What? You didn't say that, did you say that?
On that note,
I'm going
home. Could
have chosen a euphemism, at least. What did you say?
Well, I first thought of he was trolling over the side, but George wasn't too well known for his trolling, although he slept in a lot of beds through Connecticut. I said fishing.
Fishing over the side. All right, he was a little, he nonchalanted it.
The same to you and your relatives.
Yes. What did you say, Brad?
You know that wonderful nursery rhyme?
Yep.
Ding dong.
Yeah.
Bell. Right. Pussy's in the well.
Yeah.
Well, you have to ring a bell and it goes tinkling.
Tinkling. Tinkling over the side, eh? Okay. That's a euphemism. Yes, Charles?
I was going to say he was pardoning the president ahead of him, but there wasn't any. So I said... my last day. So I said eating cherry.
Super. Eating cherry?
Yes.
Oh. That's two nonchalant George Washingtons. Was he nonchalant, Michelle?
I thought he'd never get a laugh this week.
My dear.
Yes.
I had throwing up.
Oh, there it is. One for you. What do you got there?
I got plenty of nothing.
You got an answer, though. I mean, was he nonchalant doing some trifling thing, such as eating cherries?
What well, I didn't doing? Bother to answer this because I'm English and I don't know anything about.
Well, now, George Washington was the father of our country, the first
Although
president.
I do know Mr. Ford said to Mr. Nixon, George, and Nixon said, pardon. He said, you got it.
Throwing up.
Throwing up. That's good for you. All right, Betty.
Now, this may take a ruling on the part of our red-hot judges over there. Because
how would
I
you
said
know they were red-hot?
Leaning.
And he would be leaning.
Yeah, but he
You've
could be.
You've got to admit he'd be leaning.
He could be leaning over there.
So
be eating cherry.
Sure.
He could also be fishing.
Leaning over there. So you did pretty well
or
with
trolling.
That. You two. So at this depends moment, at the end of round one, scores 4-2, favor of Alicia. And we'll get back to you, ladies, in a moment or so. But right now, we've got to do a little business for you. This is it. All right. Push this button, reveal our second round questions, and ask Alicia to make a selection.
A, please.
A. Now, last time you matched four of our celebrities, so that means only two will be playing, and those two are Michelle and Betty. This is for you, ladies, and only for you.
Dumb Dora was so dumb.
How dumb was she?
I'll tell you how dumb she was, and I'm glad you asked. When her feet hurt, she took off her blank. That's how dumb she was.
I have a terrific answer for this. I wish I could.
Well, you're not playing.
Brett is not playing. You're playing, and you're finished. Dumb Dora was so dumb when her feet hurt, she took off her blank.
Surely. That's serious.
Finished. Alicia Howard. Dumb Dora was so dumb that when her feet hurt, she took off her...
gloves.
Her gloves.
Dumb Dora.
She wasn't that dumb. Oh. I don't think. Michelle, what do you say?
I was that dumb.
You were that dumb?
Yes. I said dress for lack of a better thing to think of at the moment. That buzzer is so horrifying when it comes on after a dumb
answer. It's terrible, isn't it?
It's like someone going...
You really feel bad, don't you?
I feel awful about that. I'm sorry.
Take off your dress and relax.
Yeah. Betty White.
He said Dumb Dora was dumb, not built. There'd be no reason for her to take... She took off her gloves.
Gloves! Well, I'll be done. I really didn't expect that. All right, here we go. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Now, you've got to match three to stay in the game. Four will win another game for you. Let's see what happens. The inventor said, I've added a new feature to the $6 million man. Now you can take a pencil and sharpen it in his blank. Take a pencil and sharpen it in his blank. Michelle and Richard do not play. Michelle and Richard do not play. Everyone else is playing.
No, I'm not telling you.
That's true. Yeah.
It's my last day, and I'm not telling you anymore. It's over.
Exactly.
I hope you go blind. Or at least till you need glasses.
You can't write whatever he has on my left. Put that down.
Marty, are you just an innocent bystander here? How come you didn't bring your needlepoint in between things? You could do a little
bit. I don't need a needlepoint. I need my psychiatrist between these things. These two people up here are absolutely crazy. I love Hilda, but Herman drives me out of my mind. And I can't wait. Beatrice, I'm coming home.
Okay. Here we go. Edith, the inventor said, I've added a new feature to the $6 million man. Now you can take a pencil and sharpen it in his blank.
Nose.
You got mixed reaction from the studio audience. Let's see what the celebrities say about that. She says nose.
You can't, unless you have two pencils.
Oh.
Noses are for two pencils.
Yes, for one pencil.
For one pencil, you use the ear.
The ear. Got to match everybody to stay in the game, Brett. Nose is the answer she's looking for. What do you offer?
Now, this may be a match, I'm not sure. What actually I wrote originally was whatever Charles has.
Yeah.
But I figured that wasn't right because I didn't know what he had.
Yeah.
So I put other end. Now it's all according to where you're standing.
That is not a match. So Alicia Howard wins the game. Congratulations. All right. There's $100 for you. Well, Edith, it's time to say goodbye to you, but you're not leaving empty-handed, are you?
Nope.
What do you got there, do you know?
$35.50.
That's right, $3,550. What are you going to do with all that money?
Spend it.
Good.
Thank you.
Goodbye, Edith. I was just getting to like her, and she left. And I didn't even say goodbye, and the thing started to turn there. What did you do that for? That was terrible. Come back, Edith. Come back.
She doesn't need you now. She's got money.
Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. You stand by for a moment or so. Alicia, we got to do a little business here. You watch this commercial and hurry back.
Play right now.
Don't give your right name.
Okay.
Listen, this is the end of the line here. We've got to say goodbye to all of you. It was nice having you with us the first time,
fine.
And I hope you'll come back, right?
Oh, I certainly will. Can I say something?
Yes.
Everybody go see Cuckoo's Nest at the Huntington Harford Theater because James Farentino, my husband, is there now, and it got smash reviews, and it just opened like one night ago.
Send them tickets to California while you're doing it.
I mean, all you people in on this part of the country.
Okay, Vegas, that's splendid. And Artie, you were terrific.
Oh.
And, of course, the regulars were always
terrific.
And his
terrific. New record album is wonderful.
What is that?
It's good enough for them, it's good enough for you.
Oh, well, let's get that.
It's a wonderfully funny album.
That's terrific. Why? Sure.
You know our big dog?
Yes.
Had to shoot it.
Oh, I'm sorry. Was he mad?
Well, he wasn't exactly pleased.
Oh, I'm sorry. Good night, Charles. Good luck to you.
Good luck, thank Charles, you. Charles. Goodbye.
Hurry
Bye.
Back.
Thank you, Mom.
Next time we get together, we're going to have these Kookaloo-Koos with us.
Michael Evans, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Joyce Bulafont, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Frey.
Join us next time for Match Game 74. We're all going to have a good cry now.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattle Tales next over most of the CBS stations.